إذا ما قالني ربي أما استحييت تعصيني.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. My dear respected brothers, it is from the nature of man, the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created mankind, that he becomes happy and he becomes sad. He has moments of good and happiness in his life, and he has moments of sadness and sorrow in his life. And depending on a person's environment and his situation and his iman and his belief in Allah Azza wa Jal, people's happiness varies and it differentiates. Some people, my dear brothers, there are certain things that make them happy, and it's all that matters to them. For example, some people, what matters to them and makes them happy is when their wealth increases, and that's all that matters in their life. And there are others, my dear brothers, that their happiness revolves around having more and more children, for example. Some, their happiness revolves around their work, their environment in terms of becoming more successful in life and whatever else. And there are some who their main focus is the next life, the hereafter, and everything else is secondary after that. Some people who Allah Azza wa Jal blesses, He places their happiness in His deen. And these are the ones who succeed. The one who his happiness is based on the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal, when he finds himself increasing in worship, when he finds himself doing acts of good, this is what brings him happiness. And this is the happiness that Allah Azza wa Jal expects from the believer. And that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the Quran, He says to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to address mankind, and He says to him, قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَٰلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by the virtues of Allah and His mercy, let that be why they become happy. Let that be the source of their happiness. What? The virtues of Allah, meaning the blessings that He bestows upon us, and His mercy. This is what brings happiness to the heart of the believer. That Allah Azza wa Jal has given him many blessings, and this is what brings him happiness. And the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We become happy as Muslims, as believers, when we witness and we experience the mercy from Allah Azza wa Jal. Because without His mercy, my dear brothers, we are destroyed. And we have no purpose in this life if Allah Azza wa Jal has removed His mercy from us. Why is it that His virtues, His blessings, and His mercy is the reason why we should be happy? Allah Azza wa Jal says in the same verse, He says, هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. These two things is greater for them than everything that they accumulate. Allah's mercy and His blessings, my dear brothers. It is greater than anything you can accumulate. It's greater than your wealth, your families, yourself, and everything else. And that is why this is what makes us happy as believers. Increasing in the worship of Allah Azza wa Jal. Seeing the religion of Allah prosper. This is what brings happiness to the heart of the believer before anything and everything else. When Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu wa arda, as the Khalifa of the Muslims, when they conquered one of the lands and they captured some spoils of war, part of the spoils of war was an amount of camels. And this amount of camels was being sent back to Al-Madinah to be put in Bayt al-Mal, the wealth of the Muslims. So before these camels had arrived back to Umar in Medina, he was informed of a certain number. So Umar ibn al-Khattab was told that there was X amount of camels that we have that are coming to you in Medina. So when those camels arrived, Umar ibn al-Khattab, along with one of his servants, they began to count the camels. And they counted more than what was initially told to them. So for example, if they were told there was 100 camels coming, they counted 150 camels. There was more than what was told. So his servant, the servant that counted the camels with him, he said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, and then he quoted this verse, قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا. Say, by the blessings of Allah and His mercy, let that be why they become happy. So Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu, to teach his servant and to teach the entire ummah a lesson, he said to his servant, no. He said, this is not what brings us happiness, meaning wealth. The camels are wealth. He said, this is not what brings us happiness. He said, rather happiness is in the deen of Allah. In al-Islam, and in following the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is what brings happiness to the Muslims. When you look at the lives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his sahaba, their faces would become radiant, it would light up when it referred to matters regarding the religion. Look at Abu Hurairah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. When Abu Hurairah radiyallahu anhu was very sad that his mother was not a Muslim and she would abuse the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made dua for her in front of Abu Hurairah. And when Abu Hurairah radiyallahu anhu returned home, he found his mother making wudu, and then she took the shahada. It was the happiest day of the life of Abu Hurairah. So his happiness was linked to his mother being guided to Islam. Their happiness was regarding Allah's deen, my dear brothers. So we should be asking ourselves, where is our happiness lying? Some of us, as long as we are making money, we are happy. But if we are missing salah, not attending the Jum'ah, not doing the obligations, this does not move our heart. It doesn't matter. My heart is focused on the dunya. Some people, this is how they are. And others know, they live for the next life. They do not become angry, upset, or whatever else. Their emotions are not revolved around materialistic things. But rather, their emotions are revolved around the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal. This is the reality. Some people are for this, and some people are for that. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, to show us the happiness of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, her father. She said, when my father was told by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he will be his companion in the hijrah, She said, I never saw my father cry from happiness the way he did that day. Subhanallah. Why? Because he was chosen to accompany Rasulullah on this great event, this great journey. This is what moved their hearts, my dear brothers. Their hearts and their emotions was fixed for the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the battle of Badr, before they engaged in the battle, and he had asked the companions about their opinion as to whether they should fight or not, and he heard from the Muhajirin. The Muhajirin stood up and they already showed their support to Rasulullah sallallahu that we are with you all the way. And the Prophet ﷺ was not completely satisfied until he heard from the Ansar, because they were still new in their relationship. And then when he heard Al-Miqdad ibn al-Aswad radiallahu anhu stand up and say to the Prophet ﷺ, Ya Rasulullah, are you hinting about us the Ansar, whether we support you or not? He said to him, we are not going to say to you what the people of Musa said to Musa when they said, go you and your Lord fight, and we are sitting here waiting. He said to him, we say to you, go you and your Lord fight, and we will be with you, in front of you, behind you, on your right and on your left. The Sahaba said, we saw the happiness on the face of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is what moved them, my dear brothers. Not the dunya and its materialism. Their religion is what mattered to them. So you as a Muslim, when you see the religion of Allah Azza wa Jal expanding, when you see people embracing Islam in huge numbers, when you find people being guided to the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal, when Allah allows you to worship Him, when Allah uses you for His religion, this is what should be bringing happiness to your heart. And nothing else, everything else is temporary, my dear brothers. We are in this dunya today, and tomorrow we will be in our graves. The wealth that we accumulate and we work hard for, it is ours today. Tomorrow it is not ours. As Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had invited some guests to eat, and he slaughtered a sheep for them, and then after they finished, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he asked Aisha what remains from the sheep. She said, nothing remains except a leg. They ate everything except the leg. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to her, no, Ya Aisha, rather all of it remains except the leg. Because it was a sadaqah. Everything that was eaten remains, it will be your wealth in the next life. As for the leg which was not eaten, we have lost it. Because it was not taken as a sadaqah. This is how they thought. Their focus was the next life. Their happiness was the akhirah, and not the materialism of this dunya. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سن بالسنة وصار على نهجه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد. The Muslims in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one of the times which bring them or brought them the greatest happiness that they ever experienced was when Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu became a Muslim. And that is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made the dua and he said, oh Allah, honor Islam with the Islam of one of the two most beloved to you, Umar ibn al-Khattab or Abu Jahl. He made this dua and Allah chose Umar ibn al-Khattab. And when Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu became a Muslim, the Muslims were so happy. Because his Islam was a strengthening for the deen. It was an opening for the religion. For their happiness revolved around the expansion of Allah Azza wa Jalla's deen. These days, the sad reality, my brothers, is we find people more passionate and happy over things like what? A sporting event. A sporting event more than the deen of Allah Azza wa Jalla. And this is a very sad reality, wallah. Our priorities need to be fixed. We need to fix our priorities. One of the companions by the name of Ubay ibn Ka'b radiallahu anhu, as mentioned in the hadith, he was from the Qurra of the Sahaba. The Qurra of the Sahaba, meaning he was from those who were best able to recite the Qur'an. And they were few. All the Sahaba can read the Qur'an perfectly, no doubt. But a few of the companions stood out for their recitation, like Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiallahu anhu. And Ubay ibn Ka'b was one of them. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hadith, it says that he came to Ubay ibn Ka'b and he said to him, O Ubay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered me to read surah such and such to you so you can hear it. What an honor for Ubay ibn Ka'b. Allah commanded Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to read a surah to Ubay ibn Ka'b. So Ubay ibn Ka'b radiallahu anhu was so moved by this, and who would not be moved by that? So he said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, did Allah azza wa jal mention me by my name? He said, yes. So Ubay ibn Ka'b began to cry from happiness that the Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned him by name. And there are ahadith that mention that you perform actions and deeds in your life which Allah Azza wa Jal mentions you as an individual to those in the heavens with him from the malaika. So why are we not learning these actions? Why are we not implementing them? These days, if the president or the prime minister or the leader or a hierarchy or whatever else, if he mentions our name, mashallah, we boast about it. Imagine your name being mentioned by the Lord of the worlds. How great is this? Imagine Allah Azza wa Jal focusing on you and talking to the angels about you. This is the success. This is the happiness that the believer works for. Because everything else, my dear brothers, will perish except your deeds. Your deeds is what you will take to your grave. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase us in iman. And we ask Allah azza wa jal to allow us to worship him in a way that he is pleased. And we ask Allah azza wa jal to forgive our sins and our shortcomings. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us and our families the highest levels of paradise. And we ask Allah azza wa jal to ease the affairs of our Muslim brothers and sisters worldwide and to grant victory to Islam and the Muslims worldwide. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر. والله يعلم ما تصنعون.